Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Lydia Mendelson Theater and the University of Michigan Gilbert and Sullivan Society's production of The Grand Duke or The Statutory Duel. At this time, we request that you silence all electronic devices you may have about your person, unless you wish to invoke the wrath of the Grand Duke's chamberlains. Thank you, and enjoy the show. And now, in accordance with society tradition, please rise as you are able and join us in singing God Save the Queen.
Thank you. Manager to lend us some of the Japanese costume for our wedding procession. Think of the effect of a real Japanese wedding procession cavorting through the streets. It would have been tremendous.
So he declined?
He did, on the prosaic grounds that all attending should certainly blubber and weep, and the ancient Japanese didn't carry pocket handkerchiefs. If, as is confidently predicted, Ernest Dunkroft is to succeed the dethroned one, mark my words, he will make a mess of it.
But he's short of it. The entire company has promised to plump for him on the understanding that all positions about the court are fulfilled by members of his troop, according to official precedent.
Here he comes now. Now he should go all about.
Members of your theatrical troupe Exactly so.
Then all I can say is that it places me in an extremely awkward position.
I don't see how it concerns you.
Why, don't you see that as your leading lady, I'm bound to play the leading part in all your productions?
Well?
Of course, the leading part in this production will be the Grand Duchess!
My wife!
That is another way of expressing the same idea.
I'd scarcely dare to even hope for this.
Of course, as your leading lady, you'll be mean enough to hold me to the terms of my agreement.
Oh, but...
That's so like a man. Well, I suppose there's no help for it. I shall have to do it.
Oh, she's mine! But do you think you would care to play that part?
Care to play it? Certainly not. But what am I to do? Business is business, and I am bound by the terms of my agreement.
It's for a long run, mind. One that can last many, many years. No understudy, and once embarked upon, there's no throwing it off.
We actors are used to these long runs. They are the curse of the stage.
But considering your strong personal dislike towards me, don't you think you find it hard to throw yourself into the role with all the impassioned enthusiasm?
My good sir, I've made it a rule never to allow private feeling to interfere with my professional duties. You may be quite sure that, however distasteful the part may be, yeah, if I undertake it, I shall consider myself professionally bound to throw myself into it with all the ardor at my command.
The happiest fellow alive! Now, would you have any objection? If only some idea. If it's only a mere sketch as to how you would play it, it would be really interesting. To know your conception of the part of my life.
How would I play it? Now let me see. I have it. How would I play this part? The Grand Duke's bride, all anchor in my heart. Only I gather from every collection.
nation. It's I, this gentleman, may have belonged to an association. But I'm all uncertain, yet a sausage roll I took and ate the champion. I am not diminished by eating cream and obvious bread.
My gracious pals, my gracious pals, my gracious pals, my gracious
statutory duels, when we none of us know what a statutory duel is.
Don't you?
then I'll explain. By this ingenious law, if any two should quarrel, they may not fight with falchion rights that seem to a deed immoral. But each a part shall draw, and he that draws the lowest shall sort his set me henceforth dead, in fact, the legal lowest. When exigence of right compass, or fat with feet, or goes first, thus then causes the legal lowest.
Thank you. sits on a scale of unusual liberality. Pass that on.
Liberality and morality.
Literality.
Libermality.
Triple salary.
Pepper gallery.
The sports will be with a wedding breakfast bean. All the leading pastrycooks of the town will be invited to compete, and the winner will not only enjoy the satisfaction of seeing his breakfast devoured by Grand Duke Pear, but he will also be entitled to have the arms of any company tattooed between his shoulder blades. The vice chamberlain will see to this.
Back tattoo.
Mike Raccoon.
Brass platoon.
Brass baboon.
Brass bassoon.
Brass balloon. Check.
All the public fountains of Spies Sal will erupt with ginger beer a lime and currant vine beer.
Ginger beer, Hyman. Corn's fine, Billy.
Ginger beer, corn's fine.
Beer, wine. Beer is fine.
Yeah!
Beer. Check.
Tonight, everybody will illuminate. And as I have no desire to tax the public funds unduly, this will be done at the inhabitants' private expense. The deputy assistant vice chamberlain will see to this.
Illuminate!
Remunerate.
Remunerate.
Rejuvenate.
Reduce the rate!
Hallucinate.
All my grand ducal subjects will wear new clothes, and the subject is assistant vice chamberlain will collect the usual commission on all sales.
Commission!
Commission!
Contrition!
Collision!
Collusion!
Collusion!
Wedding presents, which on this occasion are to be of a scale of extraordinary magnificence, will be received at the palace at any hour of the 24, and the temporary sub-deputy vice chamberlain will sit up all night for this purpose.
All night.
All night.
All night.
All night.
All night.
Alternate Tuesdays.
The entire population will be commanded to enjoy themselves. And with this, the acting temporary sub-deputy assistant vice chamberlain will sing comic songs in the marketplace from noon to night ball. A maestro, if you
like.
Comic
song!
Comic
song!
Comic song!
I'll keep it for supper.
no sense of delicacy.
No sense of delicacy? Bonbon!
No, I can't make you out. When you courted me, all your courting was done here, in the marketplace. When you proposed in the marketplace. And now that we're engaged, you seem to desire our first tete-a-tete occur in the marketplace. Surely, there's a room in your palace with blinds that you do.
But my home, I can't help myself. I'm bound by my own decree.
Your own decree?
Yes. You see, all of the houses that give on the marketplace belong to me, but the houses wouldn't let. So, with the view of increasing the value of the property, I decree that all love episodes between affectionate couples are to take place in public on this spot every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday when the band doesn't play.
Have you found it handsome?
Handsome? Why, the rents have gone up 50%, and the sale of opera glasses, which is a grand ducal monopoly, has received an extraordinary stimulus. So, under the circumstances, would you allow me to place my arm around your waist as a source of income?
It's so very embarrassing. Think of the opera glasses.
My good girl, that's just what I am thinking. Now, hang it all, we must give them something for their money. What's that?
Oh, it's a letter. Your detective asked I give it to you. I wrapped it around yesterday's paper to keep it clean.
Oh, it's only his report. That's a heap. Oh, but I say, you've never been and bought a newspaper.
Rudolph, do you think I'm mad? It came wrapped around my breakfast.
Ah, I thought you were not the sort of girl to go and buy a newspaper. Well, as we've got, we may as well read it. What does it say?
It's your biography. Our detested despot.
Yes, I fancy that refers to me.
And it says, oh, it can't be!
What can't be?
It says that although you're going to marry me tomorrow, you were engaged in infancy to the Princess of Monte Carlo.
Yes, that's quite right. Didn't I mention it?
Mention it? You never said a word about it.
Well, it doesn't matter, really, because, you see, it's practically off. The betrothal is void unless the princess marries before she is of age. Now, her father, the prince, is stony broke and hasn't left his house for years for fear of arrest. Over and over again, he has implored me to come to him to be married, but in vain. And as the princess comes of age at two tomorrow, why, at two tomorrow, I'm a free man. So I have opted that hour for our wedding, as I should like to have as much marriage as I can get for my money.
Oh, my popple darling. Rudolph, we ought to be very happy.
If I'm not, it will be my first bad investment.
Let us be brothers in the What's this? Another conspiracy. A conspiracy to depose me. And my detective was so convulsed with laughter at the notion of a conspirator selecting him for a confidant that he was physically unable to arrest the malefactor. Why? It will come off. And the plot is to explode tomorrow. My wedding cake. Oh, Caroline, Caroline, this is perfectly frightful. What's to be done? I don't know. I'm going to be ill. I know I have been living too low. And I'm going to be very ill indeed.
Now for my confession and full pardon. They told me the Grand Duke would be dancing duets in the marketplace, but I don't see him. Why, hello, who's this? His mustache falling off. Why, it is the Grand Duke.
Ah! Who are you, sir, who presume to address me in person? Why, if you have anything to communicate, you must first fling yourself at the feet of my acting temporary subdempty assistant vice chairman, who will fling himself at the feet of his immediate superior, and so on through the various rings. Fling, 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 fling. Your communication will, in the course of time, come to my august knowledge.
But when I inform your highness that in me you see the most unhappy, the most unfortunate, the most entirely miserable man in your whole dominion.
You, the most miserable man in my whole dominion? How you have the face to stand there and say such a thing? Why, look at me! Look at me!
Well, I wouldn't be crybaby.
A crybaby? If you had just been told that you were going to be deposed tomorrow and perhaps blown up with dynamite for all I know, wouldn't you be a crybaby? Why, I do declare that if I could only hit upon some cheap and painless method of putting an end to an existence which has become insupportable, I would unhesitatingly adopt it.
You would? I see a magnificent way out of this. By Jupiter, I'll try it. You wouldn't be by any chance in earnest, would you?
In earnest? Why, look at me!
Well, if you really are in earnest, if you really desire to escape this impending, this unspeakably horrible catastrophe, without trouble, danger, pain, or expense, why not resort to a statutory duel?
A statutory duel?
Yes. It is still in effect, but it will expire tomorrow afternoon. You fight, you lose, and you are dead. For a day. Tomorrow afternoon, when the act expires, the explosion will have taken place, and the survivor will have had to bear the brunt of it.
Yes, that's all very well, but who will be fool enough to be the survivor?
Actuated by an overwhelming sense of attachment to your Grand Ducal person, I am hesitating to offer myself to be the victim of your subject's fury.
You do? Oh, I realize it's very handsome of you. I dare say being blown up is nearly as unpleasant as one would think.
Oh, oh, but it is. It mixes one up awfully.
But suppose I were to win?
Ah, that's easily arranged. I'll put it in an ace up my sleeve, and you'll bring him up yours. When the drawing takes place, I shall seem to draw the higher card and you the lower. And there you have it.
Oh, but that's cheating.
So it is. I never thought of it like that.
Not of that kind, but you won't take an unfair advantage of your day in office. You won't go around tipping the people or squandering mental savings and fireworks or any nonsense of that sort.
I am hurt, really hurt by the suggestion.
You wouldn't like to put down a deposit, perhaps?
No, I don't think I should like
to. Or give a guarantee?
A guarantee would be equally open to objection.
It would be more regular. Oh, very well, I suppose you must have your way.
Good. I say, we have a devil of a quarrel. Now, just to give color to the thing, shall I give you a sound thrashing before all the people? Say the word, there's no problem.
No, I think not, although it will be extremely convincing and it's very good and thoughtful you suggest it. Still, a devil of a quarrel.
Oh, a devil of a quarrel.
No, half measures. A big word, strong language, a rude remark, so a devil of a quarrel.
Now, the question is, how do we summon the people?
Oh, there's no difficulty about that, bless your heart. They've been staring at us through those windows for the last half hour.
Thank you.
your time. 20 to 24 hours, this time to be new it. Centuries like a new light to be learned. It's simple to do in my jingle, I'll do it. It's fun. Till I perish your mother, goodbye, 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 goodbye.
Thank you.
Quite true. Depressing topics we'll not touch upon. Let us begin as we are going on. For this theatronic of religion and forbidden.
Gloria.
Duchess. Allow me to present your new Grand Duchess. Should she offend, will graciously excuse her and kindly recollect I didn't choose her. I may mention, though it once was our intention to restage the classic opera that Mikado as we said. We've decided we will show no fans or Romeo or kimono, and we hope you will enjoy these pipes and togas in their stead. We've acquired an automatic that is ballet operatic, to respond to the current I have that cultivated age, and our clever chorus master of a captivating pastor. Except as the courageous of the early Attic stage, this return to classic ages is considered in their wages, which is always calculated by the day or by the week. And I'll pay you if they drag me, all in Abeloy and drag me, which they'll get if they prefer it at the candidates that took me. And again, I wish to mention that this erudition sham is but classic of pretension, the result of steady cram, and a drastic method spurning to this audience discerning. I admit this show of learning is the fruit of steady cram. Perhaps they have a word or two to say, for they hadn't Mac and cautious, or umbrellas or galoshes, and a shower with the dresses must have played the very deuce, and it must have been unpleasing when they caught a fit of sneezing, for the pocket handkerchiefs they didn't know the use. They were little underclothing, scarcely anything or nothing, and a dress of flowing silk was quite transparent in design. But in fact, it's all the weather, something like the altogether, and it's very rather fancy, I should have to draw the line. And again, I wish to mention that this erudition sham is but classical pretension, the result of steady cram. Yet my classic lord aggressive, little part of the possessive, is exceedingly impressive when you're passing an exam.
Yes, it's classic lord aggressive, if the part of the possessive is exceedingly impressive when you're passing an exam.
Now, I've been considering how I can make the most of the Grand Duchess!
Well, I don't think she should be one of your hoity-toity vixenish viragos.
You think not?
No, I'm quite clear about that. She should be a tender, gentle, submissive, affectionate, but not too affectionate, child wife, timidly anxious to coil herself into her husband's heart, but kept in check by an awestruck reverence for his exalted intellectual capacities and magnificent personal appearance.
Oh, that's your idea of a good part.
Yes, a wife who regards her husband's wish as inflexible law and ventures but rarely into his august presence. A crushed, despairing violet, whose blighted existence would culminate all too soon into a lonely and pathetic death scene. A fine part, my dear.
Yeah. There's a good deal to be said for your view of it. Now, there are some actresses whom it would fit like a glove.
I wish I married one of them.
But you see, I must consider my temperament. For instance, my temperament would demand for some strong scenes of justifiable jealousy.
Oh, there's no doubt about that. You shall have them.
That detested rival.
Oh, I'll provide the rival.
Whom I should stab? Stab? Stab!
Oh, I wouldn't stab them. It's been done to death. I would treat her with a silent and contemptuous disdain. Delicately withdraw. I can see you delicately withdrawing, up center and off! Now, Julia, come consider it from this dainty point of view. A timid, tender, feminine, gender, probably quailing good. A silent seeking, seldom speaking, till she's spoken to. A sweet, oh, chimney, nimity, nimity, innocent, ingenue. The part you're suited to give the deuces due. A sweet, oh, chimney, nimity, nimity, innocent, ingenue.
You forget my special magic in a high dramatic sense. Lies in situation tragic, undeniably intense. As unjustified promotion in this history, honey, but I'll submit to you my notion of a fair.
countess now, my love.
Thank you. All the restriction, although I am merely the fiction of boys' love. Thank you. she's never had a bum, and she never take off singlets because she lives and not present a bum.
Our girls are not presentable.
But God, was he short come, he's glad of us. We explaining respect the
thank you.
visitors of distinction too? That's also performed with the foot.
Oh, really? The stone? Ah, but perhaps you have not completely grasped the situation.
Not altogether.
Oh, you from Monte Carlo also? Then I give you a lead over. I am the father of the Princess de Monte Carlo. Doesn't that convey any idea to the Grand Duke and mine?
Nothing definite.
There you are. Never mind. Try again. This is the daughter of the Prince de Monte Carlo. Do you think?
No, not yet. Do go on. It will come in time.
Very odd. Never mind. Try again. 20 years ago, little daughter, two little daughters. Happy father, hers, and yours. Proud mother, yours, and hers. Now you can. I see you do. I see you do.
Nothing is more annoying than to feel that you are not equal to the intellectual pressure of the conversation. I wish you'd say something intelligible.
You didn't expect me?
No. I grasped that. Thank you. I didn't expect you.
I thought not. But look here. At last, I am escaping from my enforced restraint. No! You misunderstand me. I mean, I have paid my debts.
Oh.
And how do you think I did it, eh? Through the ingenious medium of roulette. Where we are. Who did you see, gentlemen?
This is the gentleman I was to have married yesterday. gentleman I married this morning.
He's the gentleman I married this afternoon.
Oh, well, I'm sure. Papa, let's go away. Caesar is not a respectable court.
No. All these grand dukes had their little fancies, my love. This potent thing appears to be collecting wives. It's a pretty hobby. I should like to collect a few myself. This is a shattering specimen. An antique, I should say. I give such a thing as a catalogue of the museum.
But I cannot carry Rudolph to keep a museum.
Rudolph? I'm not Rudolph. Rudolph died yesterday.
What?
Yes. Quite suddenly of a cardiac affection.
Cardiac affection?
Yes, a pack of cardiac affection. We fought a statutory duel and I won, so I had to take over all of his responsibilities, including this imperfectly preserved older lady to whom he had been engaged with for the past 3 weeks.
3 weeks? But I've been engaged to him for the past 20 years!
20 years?!
It's all right, my love. They can't get over that. He's yours. Take him. And hold him as tight as you can.
Oh, my God!
Here's another! A fourth in 420 hours! Would anyone else like to be my wife? Maybe you? Perhaps you. Really, I'm getting used to it.
Now let me tell you.
Why, I'm interested in this. Here's another. Poor ladies. Very sorry for you all. But you see, I have a prior claim. Come away, we go. There's not a moment to be lost.
Chapter, you can't do that. Don't you ever think of a rag and tap it off.
tell him I can't.
Well, the truth is there's been a little mistake here. On reference to the act which regulates statutory duels, I find it expressly laid down that the ace shall count invariably as lowest.
As lowest!
Lowest! So you're the cellist.
Well, Julia, seeing as the law hasn't been revived, that I shall come to life in a matter of minutes.
My objection falls to the ground. Very well. Am I to understand that I was on the point of marrying a dead man without them knowing it? Oh, my lord, I never achieved like that.
You're the Princess of Monte Carlo. I returned up just in time. Well, you're in a trap, little girl, you know, but as poor as a
rather, monsieur, there you mistake. Accept her dowry with a father's blessing.
Why, what do you call this?
It's my little wheel of fortune. I'll tell you.